And earlier today, we told you that the Springfield-Greene County Health Department passed along some new potential exposure cases also in our community, five at local businesses. But our Jesse Inman is here tonight to explain and talk about the one that stemmed from a large public gathering. He spoke to the health department today. Jesse, what'd you find out?
Well, David, two people, they tested positive after attending a candlelight vigil downtown around 9 p.m. That was on Sunday, June the 7th. That was attended by hundreds of people there. Now, the health department says the two patients were not showing any symptoms but were infectious at the time, and they were also not wearing masks. There are, again, hundreds of people, as you can see from that video there, which happened to be honoring those who had died during encounters with law enforcement. Now, regardless of the type of event, Chief Medical Officer Emily Yoon with the health department reminds us that any large gathering that involves people being in a close proximity to each other increases the chances of a virus spreading. And she says that it's something that people should definitely keep in mind as we go forward.
With a large gathering, it may be difficult to really be able to track everyone who is in attendance. So, you know, if a business or, you know, event is able to keep some kind of attendance log, that would be ideal to be able to track them. But realistically, in some of these public events, it may not be possible. They should really be cautious to self-monitor for symptoms.
Now, of course, we're going to have to wait and see if others test positive for COVID-19 after being at that vigil. But Dr. Yoon stresses the importance of masking and their ability to reduce spread of infection. And one example that Director Clay Goddard has pointed to is the recent situation at Great Clips, where all involved wore masks and no new cases arose from that.